The numbers were fine. Revenue was a little bit light. It was all in the cable area, and part of it was the fact that they had a big licensing deal with Dexter last year. Operating income came in fine. It's a low multiple stock. I'm actually a little bit surprised that it's reacting this poorly, or down 2%. But it was just weakness in the cable area.
That direct-to-consumer number, 71% year-over-year growth, Alan, where did that come in relative to your expectations?
Well, that's a strong number. I don't recall exactly where it was a year ago, but up 71%. And the key, after Disney's big presentation last month, all the industry is moving to direct-to-consumer, having a better direct-to-consumer bundle. CBS has been talking about this for a while. Last quarter, they upped their three-year target. They were at 8 million. They originally had a target of going to 16 million by 2022. They raised that target to 25 million. I expect direct-to-consumer will be a big focus on the conference call today.
I mean, the real story, Bill, with CBS has been leadership tumult and merger speculation. Bring us up to speed on where we are now.
Absolutely. Maybe some of the weakness in the stock is that, ironically, because the numbers were good. That makes maybe the merger more likely to happen at numbers that might be more favorable to CBS, and exchange ratio that might be more favorable. But look, you know, there's no blocking this now. There's no stopping it now. The last two times Les Moonves stopped this merger from happening, Les is now, of course, gone. Joe Ianello is there. He's been extended to the end of the year in terms of his acting CEO role. Even though National Amusements wasn't supposed to initiate this merger, the two boards can initiate the merger. They've been having talks. It's just inevitable at this point. So,
Alan, do you agree? Inevitable?
I agree 100%. We put out a report a week ago saying we expect merger talks to begin within 60 days. I assume the ratio will be close to where the two stocks have been trading on an average 60-day or so basis. Otherwise, National Amusements would be sued. And I think there'd probably be $1 billion of merger synergy if you put the two together. And you have a greater direct-to-consumer product if you could put, for example, the Viacom children's product, the Viacom music product, and some of the other Viacom content inside of a CBS All Access.
Yeah, I mean, Bill, it's kind of ironic in the sense that when all this talk started, it seemed like maybe one side or the other was going to get a raw deal, right? CBS shareholders did not want to take on Viacom. In this current media world, it seems like, well, look, you might as well have a breadth of networks to figure out what to kind of emphasize, what to kill, and to create some kind of bundle of your own.
Well, absolutely. This obviously will add to the bundle that the CBS Viacom can offer. But, I mean, frankly, more important, there was, you know, one guy who didn't want the merger.
Right.
We have one major shareholder, the Redstone family, that's been wanting this merger for the last 2 years. Now they're going to get it. I mean, there's no stopping it. It's clear that one of the reasons, in my opinion, that they couldn't find a new CEO to take over CBS is because these merger negotiations are close and pending, and, you know, they've got to put them together, then see whether it's Bob Bakish, who, of course, was just out at the Milken conference. So to me, that seems like he's the one they're putting forward as the one who's going to be the new
CEO.
The Viacom CEO is going to be, you know, the CEO of the combined company, at least for a period of time. And then they have to see how they compete in this land of behemoths.